الحمد لله رب العالمين، صلى الله وسلم على محمد وآله وصحبه وسلم. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. Dear respected brothers and sisters, so inshallah ta'ala we're going to continue from where we left off. We are on the 29th aspect, from the aspect of the days of ignorance, by the author Shaykh al-Islam Muhammad bin Abdul Wahhab rahimahullah, explained by our Shaykh al-Allama Shaykh Salih bin Fawzan al-Fawzan hafidhahullah ta'ala wa ra'ah. So Shaykh al-Islam Muhammad bin Abdul Wahhab rahimahullah ta'ala, he said about the 29th aspect, one of their aspect of jahiliyyah, the 29th, not acting on the views of those whom they claim to follow. وأنهم مع ذلك لا يعملون بما تقوله طائفتهم كما نبه الله تعالى عليه بقوله قل فلما تقتلون أنبياء الله من قبل إن كنتم مؤمنين. But in spite of this, they did not even act on what the party, the group that they adhere to, used to believe in. As Allah points out in His saying, then why have you killed the prophets of Allah 4 times if you indeed were believers? Surah Al-Baqarah, Ayah 91. Our Shaykh Al-Allama, Shaykh Salih bin Fawzan Al-Fawzan, Hafidhahu Allah Ta'ala, he said, meaning that these Jews claim to follow what was revealed to them in the Torah. However, 2 things contradict this claim. First, he would kill the prophet. And it is not mentioned anywhere in the Torah that one should kill prophet. Rather, it states in it that one should believe in them, respect them, follow them, and take their example. So as you see here, a claim is a claim unless it is actualized, unless it is materialized. A person can claim what they want to claim, but if they don't act upon that claim, they're just claimers. Because if they claim that they follow what was revealed to them only, or their party, but they don't act upon that, then they're just claimers. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala refuted their claim. First thing is that they killed the prophet and messengers, peace be upon them. And the prophet and messenger, they must be honored and respected, and they should not be killed, because those prophet messengers, they brought to them that which did not suit their desires. It did not suit their desires. So that's why they killed them. Sheikh said, Hafidhahullah ta'ala, the second, the Torah commands them to follow Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And Allah says, الذين يتبعون الرسول النبي الأمي الذي يجدونه مكتوبا عندهم في التوراة والإنجيل يأمرهم بالمعروف وينهاهم عن المنكر ويحل لهم الطيبات ويحرم عليهم الخبائث ويضع عنهم إصرهم والأغلال التي كانت عليهم. And those who follow the messenger, the prophet, peace be upon him, who could neither read nor write. And this is, brothers and sisters, actually, it is an honor. It's a big honor for our Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, even though he was unlettered, alayhi salatu wa sallam, he could neither read nor write. And this is a big honor for him, even though he could not read or write, he taught those who could read and write. And also, if he could read and write, الكفار والمشركين, they would have used this as a strong argument against him. They would have accused him of fabricating the Quran. But since he did not know how to write and read, there's nothing they can say. That this Quran is from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. It's not from Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So the unleather, the Prophet, peace be upon him, he brought to them this Quran that challenged them. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he challenged them. Allah said in the Quran, قل لو اجتمعت الجن والإنس على أن يأتوا بمثل هذا القرآن لا يأتون بمثله ولو كان بعضهم لبعض ظهيرا. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he said he challenged the jinn and human. If the jinn and human were to get together to back each other up to bring the like of this Quran, they will not be able to bring the like of it. Even if they all come together to do it, it will not happen, because this Quran is from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So Allah said, those who follow the messenger, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, who could neither read nor write, whom they find written about with them in the Torah and the Gospel, he commands them towards good and forbids them from evil. He permits for them the lawful good things and prohibits them from the unlawful vile things. He releases from them their heavy burden and the chains that were upon them. And this is the characteristic of our noble Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam in the Torah and the Injil. But yet they conceal the truth. So they know better, but they don't want to reveal it to the people because of worldly gain, because of worldly gains. And because they want reputation, they want popularity. And also due to their jealousy and their envy and their arrogance, wal-iyadu billah. And the worst crime that you can commit is when you hide the truth while you know it is the truth, but you hide it, wal-iyadu billah. The Sheikh, he said, these were the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam characteristics mentioned in the Torah. But in spite of that, they did not believe in him. So they did not adhere to what their prophets told them, nor to what their scholars who claim to believe in them said. And they did not act upon what they said. So it shows you right there that when you have knowledge and you conceal it and you don't act upon it while you know better, this is the worst crime that you can commit. Because not only are you depriving yourself of khair, but you're also depriving your people of khair, iyadu billah. And knowledge without action is useless. Doesn't have any benefit in it. It does not have any benefit. That's why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he emphasizes in the Quran upon knowledge. The first ayah that will reveal to the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, اقرأ باسم ربك الذي خلق. اقرأ. So Allah commanded the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam to read. So knowledge. And also Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in the Quran, he said, إِنَّمَا يَخْشَى اللَّهِ مِنْ عِبَادِهِ الْعُلَمَاءُ. That only those men of knowledge fear Allah. The people of knowledge, they have the fear of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Because the more you know about your Lord, the more fear you're going to have towards Him, the more veneration you're going to have towards Him, Subhanahu wa Taala. The more taqwa, you're going to be conscious of your Lord. So likewise, Allah Subhanahu wa Taala, He said, "قل هل يستوي الذين يعلمون والذين لا يعلمون إنما يتذكر أولو الألباب." Say to them, are those who know equal to those who do not know? It's only man of understanding who pay heed. And may Allah make us from the Ulul Albab, from those who pay heed. He shows you right there that the one who has knowledge and he acts upon it, he's not like the one who does not. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sends Surah Al-Ra'd. فَمَنْ يَعْلَمُ أَنَّمَا أُنْزِلَ إِلَيْكَ مَنْ رَبِّكَ الْحَقُّ كَمَنْ هُوَ أَعْمَى إنما يتذكر أولو الألباب is the one who knows that which has been revealed to you, O Muhammad, from your Lord is the truth. Is it the same as the blind? The believer can never be the same as the disbeliever, because the believer, he knows his Lord subhanahu wa ta'ala. He knows him by his lordship, by his worship, by his names and attributes. So he has al-ilm, knowledge. فَاعْلَمْ أَنَّهُ لَا إِلَهَ إِلَّا اللَّهِ Know that there is no deity worthy of worship except Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So Allah commanded His Messenger Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam as well as the Ummah of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam to have knowledge. And he's one of the conditions of La ilaha illallah is al-ilm, knowledge. فَاعْلَمْ أَنَّهُ لَا إِلَهَ إِلَّا اللَّهِ Know that there is no deity worthy of worship except Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And if you are sincere, then you're going to act upon this knowledge. But if you are not sincere like the Jews, and they're like those who had a hidden agenda, they did not comply with the commandment of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and they did not accept Prophet Isa alayhi salam as a prophet, nor did they accept our Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam as a prophet and messenger, because he was not one of them. He was not one of them. And they were extremely envious of him, so much so that they tried to kill him, and Allah saved him from them. So the real consideration is not to have the Torah and the Injil in your hand, because the people, they have the book of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in their hand and they have access to it. But the real consideration is to act upon what's in it. As Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He condemned them and He exposed them in the Quran. For example, in Surah Al-Baqarah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, ثم قست قلوبكم من بعد ذلك فهي كالحجارة أو أشد قسوة وإن من الحجارة لما يتفجر منه الأنهار. In Surah Al-Baqarah, because of their rebellious nature, because of their sinfulness and disobedience, and disobedience and rebellion will breed what? Hardness of the heart. Because a person, when he sins against his Lord and he keeps doing the same thing over and over, then the heart, wal-iyadu billah, becomes hard, and the sins become very normal and natural to this person, wal-iyadu billah. May Allah protect us. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He said about them, then your heart hardened after that, so much so that they have become like a rock, and from the rock you see water gushing forth. Subhanallah. And this is the evil consequences of sins and the evil side effect of the sins and the rebellion and disobedience. So this is from the nature of the Bani Israel, the Jews. And he also said about them in Surah Al-Jumu'ah, مَثَلُ الَّذِينَ حُمِّلُوا التَّوْرَاةِ ثم لم يحملوها كمثل الحمار يحمل أسفارا. The similitude of those who carried the Torah, the book of Allah, Torah, but they did not implement it. They did not act upon it. It's like a donkey carrying loads of books. Do you think, my dear respected brothers and sisters, the donkey will benefit from those books? The donkey will not benefit from those books. Likewise, those among Bani Israel, or anyone Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has blessed him with knowledge. He has many books. He has a library and all that. But he doesn't act upon that knowledge. Then that those books will be his enemy on Yawm al-Qiyamah. They will witness against him on Yawm al-Qiyamah. Because he doesn't implement what's in those books. And the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, as it is in the hadith of Abi Malik al-Ash'ari radiallahu anhu, as he said sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, والقرآن حجة لك أو عليك. والقرآن حجة لك أو عليك. القرآن is either an argument for you or against you. So it would be an argument for you, an intercessor for you on Yawm al-Qiyamah, if you act upon it and you implement it. But if you don't, it will not intercede for you. Rather, it will witness against you. You see how dangerous it is. And the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he concluded the hadith. He said, كُلُّ النَّاسِ يَغْدُو فَبَائِعُ نَفْسَهُ فَمُعْتِقُهَا أَوْ مُوبِقُهَا. He said, everyone goes out in the early morning, goes out in the morning, buying and selling. So there are those that sell their soul for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Those are the winners. Those who find their soul and they act upon what Allah commands them and they stay away from the prohibition, those are the winners. And the losers are those who, al-iyadu billah, who sold their soul to the devil, al-iyadu billah. So this is very important that we understand that knowledge, we have to act upon it. And that's why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he divided the creation in Surah Al-Fatiha into three categories. The first one, those that Allah has favored from the Prophet and messengers, was Siddiqeen, the truthful one, was Shuhada, the martyrs, was Salihin, and the righteous. May Allah make us from them. And may Allah resurrect us with them. And may Allah unite us with them in Jannat al-Firdaus. And the second category are those who earn the anger of Allah, al-maghdubi alayhi. And the third category, wala al-dallin, or those who are misguided. So those who earned the favor of Allah, who earned the pleasure of Allah, and Allah has favored, those are the ones Allah is pleased with, because those are the ones who acted upon the knowledge. They acted upon the commandment of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Because the Jews, they had knowledge of the Torah, but they did not act upon it. They did not act upon it. So they have become like that donkey carrying loads of books. Because they know better. They have the book of Allah, but yet they did not act upon it. And they concealed many things that are in the book that Allah revealed to the Prophet Musa alayhi salam. So they have become from those that earn the anger of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Wala al-dallin, for those who are misguided, and those are the Christians. And that's why Al-Imam Sufyan ibn Uyayna rahimahullah, he said, من فسد من علمائنا ففيه شبه من اليهود ومن فسد من عبادنا ففيه شبه من النصارى. الإمام سفيان بن عيينة رحمه الله, he said, whoever is corrupt from our scholars, then he has a resemblance of the Jews. Because the Jews, they had the book of Allah, the Torah, but they did not act upon it. So likewise, a scholar who has the book of Allah, he memorized it and he understands it. And he has the ability to deduce rulings and deduce ruling from the Quran and the Sunnah of the Messenger of Allah صلى الله عليه وسلم. But he chose not to, عياذ بالله, because of desires, seeking this dunya, والعياذ بالله, seeking wealth, seeking reputation and the like. And that's why you see some of those who studied in Medina University, Umm al-Qura University, and other Islamic universities, some of them, they changed because of the dunya, because of the wealth that they give them, Hizbiyin, Ikhwan al-Muslimin. They give them money, they change. Now you see him now wearing a suit and trimming down his beard and compromising. And you don't hear him now talking about aqidah and manhaj, softness of the heart, political affairs and stuff like that. He's done. This is despicable. Look how Allah honored him, and now he is dishonored and despicable. So we have to be extremely careful, dear respected brothers and sisters. The Quran and the Sunnah is to be understood and also implemented, so that we would not have the characteristic of the Jews, those who knew the truth, but they did not act upon it, nor the Christians, those who acted upon ignorance. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to grant us all al-ilm al-nafi' wal-amal al-salih. Walhamdulillahi rabbil alameen. Wa sallallahu ala Muhammad wa alihi wa sahbihi wa sallim. Wassalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.